You know what? I'm gonna say it. Rare Google W. And you know why in just a moment. Nowadays, smartwatches aren't as ubiquitous as a smartphone, but they've become common enough and mainstream enough where if you're wearing one, if you're using one, if you're talking into one, if you're one of those people that do that, I don't understand them, people aren't gonna look at you as if you're a psychopath. They might look at you as if you spent way too much money on something really stupid and you're probably not good at making decisions, but at least they won't think you're weird for owning a smartwatch. As always, whilst the device class has existed for quite a while, you can thank the big dogs like Apple with the Apple Watch in 2015, Samsung with the Galaxy Watch in 2018, and the countless fitness trackers from the likes of the once independent Fitbit for making the smartwatch a common device that normal people actually use. Non-techie people, my sister has a smartwatch, I know random other people that have a smartwatch, it's just a normal thing that people might have. I have one right here. I got it as a present like 5 years ago and I never replaced it because it does everything I need it to do. But especially among tech circles, there is one former company with somewhat of a cult following now, with a simple device with a color e-paper display. A device that doesn't need to do everything. You don't need how to scroll Twitter on a watch. You don't need how to play YouTube videos on a watch. But instead, bringing you your notifications, letting you see the weather, letting you control your music, because this is the feature set that is actually useful. And by being a much more limited device, it has a good battery life. I don't want to charge a watch every single day. That is stupid. You can make it so it's wireless charging, just put it on this thing. I'll forget. I don't want to do that. This thing here lasts like 3 weeks. That's useful. Now, this device has nothing to do with the company. It's just the device I happen to have. The device that I'm talking about is the Pebble smartwatch. First started as a Kickstarter project in April of 2012 with a simple goal of $100,000. Reaching 4.7 million in the first 30 days, and by the time it closed, $10.2 million with 68,929 backers, almost a very nice number. Keep in mind, this is long before smartwatches became a completely normal thing to have. It was still a couple of years before the Apple Watch, it was many years before the Galaxy Watch, and yes, things like Fitbit had been around for quite a while at this point. I believe they started in 2007, but the whole smartwatch device class was very new, and people didn't really know what they wanted from them. People didn't really know what made sense to put into a smartwatch, and this seemed like a really compelling device. Now, yes, it was from a startup. Yes, it was a Kickstarter project. So, of course, there were delays, there were production issues. This is just what you get from Kickstarters and startups. It just makes sense. However, they delivered the smartwatch. And they didn't deliver this smartwatch that was like, ooh, kinda bad. No, they delivered the thing they said they were going to deliver. And a lot of people were really happy with it. Now, of course, the mainstream tech media gave it relatively middling reviews, especially back then that nobody really knew what a smartwatch was supposed to be, so it's kind of hard to take that seriously. A lot of people on YouTube really liked it though. Following this in 2015, there was another Kickstarter, this time for the Pebble Time, but more importantly, the Pebble Time Steel. This is the device that got me very interested in Pebble, because the problem I have with smartwatches, especially today, is they all look stupid. I don't want to wear an Apple Watch. I think it looks ridiculous. This is classy though. Now, the bezel is a little rough, and that is something the founder is very aware of in retrospect. Putting that aside though, this is a very nice looking device. This was another blowout success, this time 78,471 backers, but raising $20 million. But sadly, I didn't have a job back then, so I didn't buy one. If this came out today, even just release the literally same device, I would probably buy it as is. Then in 2016, we saw the next Kickstarter, the third generation Pebble, the Pebble 2, which is kind of confusing because first gen was the Pebble, second gen was the Time, then third gen is the 2. Yeah, this one has a smaller bezel. It's still bigger than they would have liked, but all around, mostly a better device. It had a bit less water resistance. Also, look at when this came out. It was a 3G wearable. Keep in mind, this came out quite a few years ago. Now, whilst this Kickstarter was another success, 66.6 thousand backers, $12,779,000 raised, problems started to happen. Now, the problems actually happened earlier, but they started to show themselves here. Parts of the company were sold to Fitbit. Shipments were delayed. Refunds were promised back in 2017. Some of them had to wait a couple of years to get a refund. And this final launch of the Pebble was enough to burn a lot of people. And that makes sense, right? Like, you fund this project. There were multiple projects before this which did do well. And then everything, even though it seemed like a really popular device, everything just collapsed basically out of nowhere. Now, in 2022, the founder, Eric Makovsky, basically talked about what happened, the success and failure at Pebble. So, in short, he got cocky. That's the simplest way to put it. He thought the device was a lot more popular than it actually was. With the Pebble 2, which looked like everything was going fine, he targeted $100 million in sales, but only did $82 million, which, yeah, $82 million is a lot of money, but if you order for $100 million, you have a problem. Whilst it was super popular amongst techie people, this was now competing with the first generation Apple Watch, and it failed to properly define a focus. What is this device? Who is it targeting? Why would someone want to buy the Pebble? Then the Pebble 2 was basically an attempt to bring the company out of the hole it now dug itself into. And to do that, even though it was a more featureful device, they had to cut costs in a lot of places, but ultimately ended up losing money on that as well. However, they still had a lot of very interesting tech, and Fitbit came along and basically wanted it. Random fun fact, the founder of Pebble also went on to found Beeper, which recently got acquired by Automattic. Automattic, the owners of WordPress. But Pebble is our focus here. So now, after 8 years since the death of Pebble, you know what? You still can't beat a Pebble. Pebble is back. We're making new Pebble watches. I've tried pretty much every other smartwatch on earth, yet I still wear my Pebble every day. Nothing else matches its features and long battery life. I really, really, really hoped someone else would create a proper replacement, but no one has stepped up and my stash of old Pebbles is dwindling. It's time to take matters into my own hands. A small team and I are working on a new Pebble-like smartwatch that runs the open source Pebble OS, has the same beloved features, plus some new stuff, and stays true to the core Pebble vision. Now, when he says Pebble OS here, this is not some random unrelated thing. So remember how I mentioned Google W earlier? Well, Fitbit purchased Pebble in 2016, and then Google purchased Fitbit in 2020. So all of the IP from Pebble now owned by Google. And here is a blog from Google Open Source. See the code that powered the Pebble smartwatches. This is fully available over on GitHub. Now, there are some proprietary firmware components and things like that that had to be removed because they just don't own the license to it. So the code in its current state doesn't actually build, which is a problem. Those parts will have to be re-implemented. However, everything else, open source, available under an Apache 2.0 license. Now, I mentioned there was a cult following of the Pebble, so of course, even though the company disappeared and Fitbit wasn't doing anything with the IP, Pebbles didn't just die immediately. There was a community project called Rebel. They were keeping the App Store alive, providing documentation, things like that, and they are very, very happy about open sourcing the operating system, because whilst this wasn't done specifically for Rebel, it's nice that they have it, but this now makes it a lot easier to develop updates for those old Pebble devices, because people are still using them. Yes, a lot of them are breaking. Yes, a lot of them aren't in as good of a state as they were before. But as long as they still work, people are going to want to use them. And if people want to use 20-year-old ThinkPads, people are going to want to use 8-year-old smartwatches. Now, this didn't just happen out of nowhere. You don't have a project like this, and then Google, and then the revival of Pebble all at the same time, without some work going on in the background. So, over the last year, a team inside Google, including some amazing ex-Pebblers turned Googlers, has been working on open sourcing the OS. The source code available there. Thank you so much, Google. I can't stress how thankful I am to the individuals who did the heavy lifting. This was also made possible by the Rebel team and the community who have supported Pebble since it shut down. Google was basically just sitting on the OS without really doing anything with it, and this is a great way to just get a bit of extra goodwill and also allow a part of the market that just isn't being served to be brought to life. Even though we have things like the Apple Watch and the Galaxy Watch and the Pixel Watch and all of these other watches, this is the kind of device that I would buy, and I am very, very excited to see what actually comes out of this new Pebble. Eric also wrote a blog over on his personal site, why we're bringing Pebble back. I wear my Pebble every day, it's been great, and I'm astounded it lasted 10 years. But the time has come for new hardware. You'd imagine that smartwatches have evolved considerably since 2012, and they absolutely have. They've just turned into these weird hybrid phone things, and I want nothing to do with them. I've tried every single smartwatch out there, but none do it for me. No one makes a smartwatch with the core set of features I want. Always on e-paper screen. It's reflective rather than emissive, sunlight readable, glanceable, not distracting to others like a bright watch. Yes, that does mean that it's not usable in the dark. But you have a phone, just use the phone. The watch can be a watch. Long battery life, one less thing to charge, it's annoying to need extra cables when traveling. I want at least a week of battery life. I can accept 5 days. I don't want anything less than that. I don't want to charge your watch every single day. That's stupid. As simple as that. Simple and beautiful user experience around a core set of features I use regularly. Telling time, notifications, music control, alarms, weather, calendar, sleep / step tracking. Not all of these other stupid things you can do with a smartwatch. Again, you don't need full fat Android or iOS in a watch. Yes, it's technically a wearable version of it, but it's stupid. It doesn't need to exist. Buttons to play, pause, skip music on my phone without looking at the screen. There are a lot of cases where gesture controls just don't make sense, and I don't want to talk to my watch. I know you can do smart assistant stuff, but I don't want to talk to my watch. Just give me a button. But also, make sure those buttons are used sensibly, because you can have buttons and then have some weird esoteric way of interacting with the device. And a big one for me, hackable. Apparently, you can't even write your own watch faces for the Apple Watch. Yes, that is actually a thing. That is wild. There were 16,000 watch faces on the Pebble App Store. Obviously, not every single person is going to want to pull the SDK out, read some documentation, and write some app or write a watch face or anything like that. Completely understandable. But by having a device that is hackable, other people can go and do so. You can have a community of applications for this device, and that makes the device way more powerful because there's only so many apps that you can make internally and so many apps that make sense for the device itself. Like, you don't want to just cram it with every single thing that maybe one person is going to use. Over the years, we've thought about making a new smartwatch. Manufacturing hardware for a product like the Pebble is infinitely easier now than 10 years ago. There are plenty of capable factories, and Bluetooth chips are cheaper, more powerful, and energy efficient. The challenge has always been, at heart, software. It's the beautifully designed, fun, quirky operating system that makes Pebble a Pebble. And now it's open source. This time around, we're keeping things simple. Lessons were learned last time. I'm building a small, narrowly focused company to make these watches. I don't envision raising money from investors or hiring a big team. The emphasis is on sustainability. I want to keep making cool gadgets and keep Pebble going long into the future. The new watch we're building basically has the same specs and features as the Pebble, though with some fun new stuff as well. It runs open source Pebble OS, it's compatible with all Pebble apps and watch faces. If you had a Pebble and loved it, this is a smartwatch for you. I didn't have a Pebble and I wanted one, so I'm almost certainly going to be picking one up. We don't know when it's going to happen, we don't know if it's going to happen. It's entirely possible this just doesn't really manifest into anything. But watch this space. I am very excited for it. Are you or were you a Pebble fan? Are you very interested to see what comes out of this? Do you want to just mess around with them because you like programming things? I'd love to know. Let me know down below. I'm very excited for this. I really, really hope this happens. And I really hope we get something like the Pebble Time Steal again. That would be very nice. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out our Patreon, subscribe, to Libero, hey, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And I'm going to throw a rock at you.